Hi everyone! It's a pleasure to see you again for another edition of All About Apps from the Clever Road Studio. Today we're going to talk about the best approaches to creating web design. Let's go! The variety of devices to serve the internet is growing progressively, and so there is a need to create solutions which can meet the requirements of all the diversity of browsers and screen sizes. A website should look great on any device running any browser – Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Safari, and so on. Today, we will delve deeper into the definition of responsive and adaptive mobile web design, what differences are, and how to choose which one to follow. Despite both, responsive and adaptive designs strive to accomplish the same task. There are different methods within these approaches. The idea of responsive web design is that you have one website for all devices and browsers, where the content is like a water and shapes perfectly according to the browser's screen size. Websites must have the following components: flexible layout, flexible media, and media queries. Grid-based or flexible layouts allows you to adjust one layout to different devices and browsers, where the content changes proportional to the screen size. The trick is that instead of pixels, you use percents and EM for fonts. This site page will change relatively to the size of browser's window, and the elements will adjust proportionally. Flexible images and media. An image changes proportionally according to the relative blocks, but never becomes wider than the block where it's situated. Media queries are a part of CSS standard. They are used in responsive website development to optimize a picture according to a certain device's screen resolution, where the website might be opened. All in all, mobile responsive design doesn't really care about devices. Its main aim is to make a website which automatically conforms to changing browser sizes and has one set of code. How do you know that the site is responsive? You just drag your browser's corners to emulate different screens. If the content starts to shrink smoothly and continues to look good as it becomes smaller, chances you are having mobile responsive web design. Another approach to create good-looking web products which adjust their design to different screen sizes and browsers is to follow the adaptive design. The main philosophy of adaptive design is creating the best user experience, where a website is accessible without any technical restriction. This approach is based on operations with different layouts and certain pre-specified devices and screen resolutions. The adaptive design uses a progressive enhancement and graceful degradation strategies of development within its approach. According to the progressive enhancement strategy, you start creating your website which meets all the requirements of the oldest browsers. And then, step by step, you create a website which looks great on the most contemporary and powerful browsers. This strategy is considered the best choice if you strictly follow the adaptive design principles. Graceful degradation strategy achieves the same goal as the progressive one, but in an opposite way. You first create a website which looks the best on the most used and contemporary browsers, and then simplify it to make it appropriate for the oldest browsers. When choosing which approach is suitable for your site, remember that none of them is better or worse than the other. Just take into account the following things before making the final decision. Responsive websites are a good idea if you are limited in time and financial resources, you have a simple, clean design and functionality without the necessity to adapt it to various needs, and your aim is to increase the speed and ease maintenance of the update process of your website. Adaptive websites will be a great choice if you're absolutely sure that you need an audience with a wide spectrum of devices, if you have both time and financial resources to create and maintain several variants of your product. Okay, that's all we've got for you today. If you want to know more about benefits and drawbacks that accompany each approach, you're welcome to read the full article. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel in order not to miss the upcoming.